Well, good morning, everybody, and pleasure to be back again today. And today I'm going to give you an overview about what we can do to really keep our skin looking healthy and really focus on kind of decelerating the aging process in our skin. Yesterday, I kind of went over a quick overview of what we're doing in general with anti-aging, but today the focus is on skin. So with that, I mean, one of the key things to keep in mind is that NARA is one of the newer additions to the YES, the Youth Enhancement System for Jeunesse. And what's interesting is it's really one of the first approaches to treating the skin from the inside out rather than the topical things that you see for most other companies. But more importantly, NARA is, again, part of the synergy, the synergistic approach to skin aging and improving the quality of your skin with the other YES system products, and we're going to get into that in a minute. So if you take a look at how people age, okay, here's Harrison Ford. Now, what's happened to his skin? Okay, there's a number of factors that occur with every one of us. So skin ages through maybe four key concepts. Number one, intrinsic skin aging, which has to do with the aging process we talked about yesterday. That is free radicals causing damage to your skin cells, so they're not focusing, your stem cells decreasing in number, so they can't make new skin-forming cells. The second thing is extrinsic skin aging, and people here in Australia unfortunately have a genetic predisposition to being damaged by the sun more often, and that has to do with your history as far as how most people from Australia came here from England and that area of Europe, where you have a genetic predisposition to have more sun damage, which causes more wrinkles. Okay, the third thing is as we age, we lose key hormonal levels. Testosterone, growth hormone, estrogen, all of those things drop. And they cause certain changes in your facial skin as well. So when it comes to aging, it's genetic, it's intrinsic aging, it's extrinsic solar radiation, environmental things, and hormonal changes. Now, you say, well, that's a lot of stuff. What can I do about that? There's a lot you can do about that, and we're going to talk about that. So Harrison Ford, we take a look at him in his mid-30s, and we take a look at him today in his 70s. He hasn't done too bad. He's got some sun damage. The deep folds in his around his nose are due to drops in mainly growth hormone. He's lost some fat in his central portion of his face, which happens to pretty much everybody as we age. And we're going to talk about how all those things can be improved. Now, here's an example of pretty poor, very poor facial aging. And unfortunately, Robert Redford here at his height, and today in his mid to late 70s, he's lost a lot of, you'll see a lot of sun damage, and that's all the fine lines. The hollowness underneath his eyes is, again, usually due to key drops and key hormones. But again, he is genetically predisposed to more sun damage, which means his skin is going to wrinkle much more quickly. Here's our infamous Dr. Trump, President Trump. Here in his 50s, late 40s, 50s, here today, you notice the bags underneath his eyes. And his skin also has, he has a genetic predisposition to premature aging due to his skin's inability to handle solar radiation. But if you'll take a look also at how his face has changed. See here in his younger face, his face is more oval. As we age, we lose volume in the central portion of the face. We get more volume laterally, and we go from oval to square. The bags underneath his eyes usually indicate his thyroid levels are low. And in general, if you look, his hair's changed colors. I don't know if that's for real or not, but bottom line is that happens. And when we start to lose our hair color, that also is a sign of telomere shortening and premature free radical damage. So when you look at someone's face and their facial skin in general, you get a very good idea of how their body is handling the aging process. Now here's an example of a little bit the opposite. Jennifer Lopez here in her late 20s, early 30s, and today. She even looks a little better. A little plastic surgery helps. But on the other hand, on the other hand, she has thick skin. She's Latino. I'm Sicilian, okay? And I just turned 67, Rome. So my skin is thick. I don't have wrinkles, okay? Wrinkles don't run in my family. And we look very, very good on the outside. We usually rot out on the inside. But the bottom line is I was smart enough to know that. So 20 years ago, I started to change my regimen and my genes so that inner thing works a lot better. But take a look at her. So what do we have? Her face looks fuller. She hasn't. She still has that oval look. She takes good care of her skin. And she's probably had a few other things to keep her volume up. But the point of the matter is that this is a genetic plus. When you have thicker skin in general, you can handle solar radiation better. And usually, people in the entertainment industry really do their best to exercise and to stay good looking. So in our 20s, what do we have? We have nice, thick epidermis. That's the barrier that keeps the moisture from escaping, okay? Our collagen and elastin levels are really, really good. Our face, the underlying fatty tissue in our face, in the hypodermis, believe it or not, is now becoming more and more important to keep you more youthful looking, because that's where your stem cells are. And that fatty tissue, when you're young, produces certain products that stimulate your cells in the dermis to make more collagen and elastin. So the 20s are great. Also, women have a big advantage over men here because their estrogen levels keep their skin not only plump, but it helps make more collagen. Now you go into your 30s, you begin to see the loss of collagen and a decrease in some of that stem cell activity, which is why, for instance, the Lumines skincare products that have the proteins that are produced by the fat cells in humans, why they help stimulate more and more collagen and elastin, because they're replacing what the aging process loses. You start to see the beginning of wrinkles here in your 30s. But why is that? That's because the dermis, okay, starts to thin out because we're not making as much collagen, and the muscles are starting to pull on your skin and they start to wrinkle some more, which is why many people like Botox, because that stops your muscles from wrinkling, and it's not just a wrinkle hider, it's a wrinkle preventative. So I have many patients who start using Botox in their late 20s because they don't want their muscles to pull on their skin and create the wrinkles. Whatever turns you on, we have solutions to things. So in the 40s, so what happens? The wrinkles get deeper, okay? Now you start to see the accumulation of solar radiation. Now why is UVA and UVB damage bad? Okay, UVA damage is what creates damage to the DNA in your skin. When that skin, when the fibroblasts that make the collagen and elastin get damaged, they don't produce collagen, they don't produce elastin, and they don't produce a key compound called hyaluronic acid. You've probably seen that in creams, hyaluronic acid. Don't buy it, because none of it gets through your skin. It's a marketing thing. Your skin, your body normally makes hyaluronic acid, and that's the substance, the jelly substance between cells. Now that holds the water. That's why your skin looks moist when you're young, because you make a lot of hyaluronic acid and it holds the water. Okay, so what happens is, as this damage accumulates in your skin, your outer portion of your skin gets thicker. That's the dead layer that protects you. So what happens is it gets thicker, and if the skin doesn't turn over on the surface of your skin, you can't let new skin cells come up. And what happens is the skin doesn't look youthful, it doesn't look pink, and it actually doesn't hold more, it actually loses more water or moisture content. So now we get into the 50s, and now you start to see deep wrinkles because those muscles have been pulling on the thinned out dermis. You're not making hyaluronic acid, so your skin isn't plump. You're not making estrogen. You're not making enough estrogen, testosterone, and growth hormone, and you're not making collagen and elastin and hyaluronic acid. So you really have a situation here from 50s on where the skin starts to look not so pretty. Okay, so if we take a look at what happens from, let's say this first person on the left is in their 40s, 50s, 60s, every decade you're losing 10% of your collagen. 10%. That means over 30 years, you're losing 90% of your facial collagen, which is why we start to look like prunes as we get older. And it's not a pretty sight. And up until about the last decade, there wasn't much we could do about it, but today we have a whole armamentarium of things we can do, particularly from the inside out and the outside in. So losing this much collagen, again, is directly related to those factors: genetic, environmental, your health, your lifestyle, and what you're eating and taking supplements. So let's take a look at this. I showed this yesterday, but I want you to see that developmentally, as a child, our skin and our fatty tissues are making tremendous amounts of things to stimulate collagen and elastin, so we have very youthful looks. When we hit our 30s, we start to, our our hormones start to drop, the DNA damage starts to increase, okay, we start to see a little kind of sagging of the skin. Now we're in our 40s, okay, and you see how the face is hollowing out underneath the eyes. The hair is turning gray. The skin is getting lax because the muscles now are also getting lax. And bingo, you just saw a lifetime of aging in 20 seconds. But it's all related to what we just talked about. Okay, so Generation Young. Everybody here wants to look better because if you look better, you feel better about yourself and you interact with everyone better. And we just finished a book called The Virtue of Vanity. Nice title, right? Everybody says vanity is really not a good thing. So what we found out is people who don't care about how they look are not only depressed, they live shorter lives and their quality of their lives is poor. People who are obsessed with plastic surgery and injections and other things are also, to the far right, they usually have an unhappy life. But people who have a desire to look good, feel good, and do certain things so that their appearance is improved as they age, have the best quality life. So having a little bit of virtue, a little bit of vanity is actually a virtue. It's not a negative thing. And the secret is to keep that focus on yourself to a healthy level. And we actually have the data to show that people live longer, their environment, their emotional relationships are better. So this is about having an opportunity to feel and look better, which probably we're the first decade of the first generation of human beings to actually be able to do that. So your skin. Your skin is your body's largest organ. I think if you remember yesterday, I told you that if you look at someone's skin, you have a very good idea of how they're aging. So when we talk about NARA as something that helps you your face look better, what we really haven't talked about in the past, and we should, is NARA helps the skin of your whole body look better. And there are many, particularly women, who lose their estrogen content. You'll notice the skin on your arms or above your knees starts to look a little crepey. Okay, men have a little advantage over that because their skin's thicker. And testosterone actually gets converted to estrogen for men, so they can continue to have better quality skin than women. On the other hand, women are born with longer telomeres, which is why they usually live longer than men do. So there's pros and cons, okay? But the point of the matter is here is that NARA isn't just for your face. You'll see an improvement in the tops of your hands. You'll see an improvement in the décolleté area. You'll even see improvement in other parts of your body with NARA. So keep in mind, this isn't just for your face, okay? So if we take a look at skin under the microscope, what do we see? These are the basic layers. The epidermis is the dry, kind of dead layer of the skin, which is the barrier. It keeps moisture in and keeps the damage from the sun. Now, if the epidermis gets thicker, your skin looks crummy. Now, for instance, the Lumines products in the Lumines skincare line, the cleanser is an exfoliative cleanser. So when you're cleaning your face, that cleanser not only cleans the bacteria and environmental dirt off your face, it actually stimulates cells to come up quicker, so your epidermis is renewed, it's thinner, and you look better. Microdermabrasion is kind of a medical version of the same thing. People come in for microdermabrasion once or twice a month. Their skin looks much better because the dead outer layers are removed and new skin can grow up quicker. Your dermis is where the fibroblasts, the cells that make more collagen and elastin and hyaluronic acid sit. Now, as they get damaged from sun or from the general internal aging process, they don't make those compounds as well, which is why, for instance, Lumines products with the stem cell growth factors will reawaken those fibroblasts that are not really doing their job and help them make more collagen and elastin and hyaluronic acid, which holds more moisture. There's reasons for each one of the products in the Lumines skincare line. They're not just thrown there together. It's all based on the science of skin aging. The hypodermis, the fatty area, is the new area of research today. And what we're seeing is when we transplant fat cells below the surface of the skin, and we transplant them with certain growth factors that could actually make the stem cells that are found in fat cells turn into new baby fat cells, the skin looks better, not initially, gets better for 3, 4, 5, and 6 years later because the baby fat cells produce the key compounds that stimulate the skin, the cells above to make collagen and elastin and hyaluronic acid. So we're now understanding the importance of fat. It's not just for volume. It's where the stem cells reside and actually turn into new baby cells that turn into new fibroblasts, which turn into collagen and elastin. So that's a quick overview of what happens with the skin. So if we take a look at, again, the skin, yesterday I said, you know, the dust in your house is really you, okay? That's your skin, your body shedding your skin cells. But every minute, 30,000 of those skin cells die, every minute. So now you're understanding the importance of keeping your body in a state of positive restoration or regeneration. If you're not making new skin cells, your skin isn't going to look good, and not just your face, your whole body. So wrinkles. Nobody likes wrinkles, right? Unless maybe you're an elephant. But bottom line is, here's what happens, wrinkles. Wrinkles occur because you lose certain hormones, okay, that keep your dermis and your dermis and your fatty layers nice and full and thick. So as we age and we lose key hormones that keep the muscle tone nice and tight, the muscle tone gets lax, the skin gets lax, and you start to create a wrinkle. So we also lose a lot of water in the surface of the skin, okay? We have the barrier, the epidermis, which does help avoid the skin being evaporated out of the skin losing water via evaporation. But the big concept of maintaining your skin hydrated and looking youthful is to create hyaluronic acid. Now, hyaluronic acid, as I said, is a protein that is between the skin cells that acts as a sponge and holds water. And as we age, we don't have hyaluronic acid. How many people have heard of Juvederm or the injectables, the fillers? Guess they're pure hyaluronic acid. Why do they work? It's because when we inject them in certain areas of the face, they not only puff up the volume and they're replacing the hyaluronic acid that you had when you were young, but they hold more water. So that's why they last a year or two. Today's new products last 2 years. And we have new ways of injecting them, not just in wrinkles, but we're now injecting the whole face with a little gun that injects micro injections through the whole face. In about 15 minutes, we do the whole face, and we completely restore the hyaluronic acid levels. Now, that's not just for cosmetic reasons, because when your face has more hyaluronic acid and more moisture content, the nutrients that you're eating can get into the cells better also. So there's reasons for all of this. So collagen production. If you're a female and you're in your 30s, you start to get drops in estrogen and progesterone. It's mainly estrogen. As the estrogen levels drop, you're making less hyaluronic acid, less collagen, and your skin starts to thin out. All the little fine lines, women, you notice women get a lot of fine lines here, and you don't see that in men, really. Why is that? It's not fair, right? Well, the point of the matter is that these are not smoker's lines. So no matter what you hear, it's, oh, she's got smoker lines. That's a complete fallacy. These are due to estrogen drops because the muscles around the lips are so active that they thin out your dermis very quickly. And as soon as you stop having the right amount of estrogen, you don't make the collagen and elastin. And here's where you'll see it first. Very few men will have this because their testosterone levels, even though they drop, a lot of that gets converted to estrogen. And they keep on making it where women don't. Not fair, but then you guys live longer. Women live longer. I don't know if that's good or bad. So we lose fat. Why do we lose fat? Because as we age, usually our insulin levels and our cortisol levels go up. If the insulin and cortisol levels go up, that they digest fat. So taking things that keep your insulin and cortisol levels nice and even, like AMPM, like the Zen products, decrease insulin and cortisol and help your body stay actually more youthful looking even at the level of your skin. So genetic, environmental, lifestyle factors, all of these things have a lot to do with how your skin on your face, hands, and neck looks, because that's the exposed area, but also your whole body. Okay, so young skin, in summary, is a nice thick dermis. You notice the collagen fibers are nice and ordered, they're nice and straight. As you age, the collagen fibers get cross-linked and they start to get disoriented and they don't keep the skin looking nice and firm. If your blood sugar is high, if you're a diabetic or you eat a lot of sugar, which is probably the worst thing to do to keep youthful skin looking, your collagen gets cross-linked and your skin starts to sink. So eating sugar is probably one of the worst things to do. And not eating fish or other foods that have anti-inflammatory compounds is another issue. Because when if you have a lot of sugar and your collagen gets cross-linked, what happens is you produce more free radicals and more inflammation. I'm giving you the whole story on skin aging very quickly today, but I want you to understand. So proper skincare is not just about skincare from the outside. It's about beauty from the inside. And skincare from the inside. So Nara has been created to kind of solve a lot of the problems that occur with skin aging: collagen, elastin, hyaluronic acid production, inhibiting free radicals. All of those are part of what the ingredients do. We're going to talk about what each one of those groups of ingredients do in a minute. If you look at the Lumines skincare product line, what is in that? That's the environmental protection. That's the products to help you buffer your genetic predisposition to be exposed to more sun exposure and more DNA damage. So if you're going to be doing a skincare regimen that gives you the optimal results, you want to use mainly three products in the Lumines skincare line. You want to use the serum in the morning because it has the growth factors from stem cells to stimulate your stem cells to make more collagen and elastin. You want to use the evening night repair, which repairs the damage that's occurred throughout the day. Okay, it also decreases inflammation. You want to use, for instance, the sunscreen, which is in the daily moisturizer. So those three core products, along with Nara and AMPM, will create the optimal effect on your skin, which will be dramatically noticeable in a matter of a few weeks. So Nara is really about fighting the skin aging problem from the inside out. Okay, so what is in Nara? Okay, what makes you Nara unique is a pro-collagen mix from fish. And it's mainly from tilapia and two types of red snapper. And those collagen-activating ingredients, which contain arginine, lysine, pro-collagen mixtures, really, really make a difference in what your body is able to use to make more of that collagen. So 70% of the protein in your face is actually collagen. 30% of protein in your body, your ligaments, your joints, is collagen. And if we're not taking an extra source of collagen, our ligaments get weaker, actually bones get weaker, and our skin doesn't look well. So this is another key area of, if you will, anti-aging that we've really finally started to understand, that collagen is very, very important. Here I was talking before about collagen as your blood sugar levels go up and you have more sun damage, instead of these fibers being nice and straight, they start to interconnect and they don't support the skin in an optimal fashion. So what's in Nara? Okay, so Nara is not only the pro-collagen or collagen necessary compounds, it's vitamin C, B12, C, E, zinc, niacin, helps with DNA repair, B6 helps with DNA repair, biotin helps make more hyaluronic acid. Pantothenic acid, again, helps with making new dermal elements. So you not only get the collagen ingredients, the building blocks of collagen, you get these key vitamins and minerals, which also help limit the damage from free radicals, which are produced from the sun and from the general aging process. So superfruits. Okay, why do we want these? These are, again, a source of natural antioxidants that buffer free radicals. Okay, and free radicals, why do we not like them? So when free radicals create damage in your skin, they actually turn on certain compounds called metalloproteases and collagenases. Anything with an ACE is not a great card when it comes to skin aging. Anything with an ACE in it is bad. So bottom line is they digest collagen. Metalloproteases and collagenases, which are stimulated by solar radiation, get turned on, and they start to eat up the collagen and elastin and hyaluronic acid in your skin. So all of you who love being in the sun, you should buy a self-tanner after 30 if you want to do your face and hands, because although it's great for vitamin D, and if you want to take sun, you should take it in the morning before 11:30, and take it in the afternoon from like 4 to 5, you'll still get plenty of vitamin D, but you won't get the damage from the intense rays that you would get otherwise. So Nara is a tangerine-flavored drink, and If you don't like tangerines, well, I guess you got a problem. But bottom line is, you get to learn to like it, because when you see the difference from Nara, you'll see. 5,000 milligrams of new collagen-based building products are in each drink. Okay, and if you take a look at what the clinical trials have shown, there's a 5% decrease in age spots. So why do we get age spots? Because as you accumulate more sun damage, a pigment in your skin called melanin starts to get more active. And what happens is it clumps together and you get a spot. When you're young, you have melanin, but it doesn't clump together because there's not enough damage to start to cause that event. So your pigmentary spots get better. There's a reduction in your pore size because collagen is more abundant and it causes your pores to close. 8% see a reduction in wrinkles because the skin is tighter. 10% see an improvement in the skin texture, that is, the turgor, the skin looks a little tighter. And 68% see an improvement in general. 68% is a good number. If I see anything above 55 to 60%, a product is a good product. Okay, superfruits, we talked about, they're the main source of antioxidants. When you use this with AMPM, you get a super abundance of antioxidants, and which really make a difference in your skin aging. Amino acids, minerals we talked about that are also a part of this formula. And in summary, when you take a look at the inside-out approach to healthy-looking skin, not just of your face, but your neck, your skin, your knees, your elbows, your arms, what you see here is probably the best combination you can have, because we talked about the benefits of AMPM yesterday with helping to restore even growth hormone levels and other hormone levels at night. We talked about AMPM helping to restore the basic function of our stem cells and our body cells, and when those cells are working more optimally, they can respond to the ingredients in the other products better. So you're working from the inside out with AMPM, you're working from the inside out with Nara supplying the collagen building blocks that you need, an increased amount of antioxidants to buffer the free radicals, and things that help in general to really restore, make a big difference in the skin of your body in general. So in general, what I can tell you is that the YES system, again, is not about just developing products to do a function. It's about developing products that, as you use them and you work together, you get a synergistic effect. You get a more profound and noticeable effect. And as I said yesterday, the YES system is about products that are experiential. You feel or see the difference. The products that are designed to work in synergy, which is a big thing. And they work from the inside out and the outside in. Now, those three concepts make Juness unique. And I've looked at all the other MLMs who are competitors, direct selling companies that are competitors. They do not understand the concept that we at Juness do, that products are not just another product to satisfy a need for what the market demands. This is about true science and about really learning and understanding the science behind skin aging and body aging in general. So with that, I hope you guys are now all experts. We'll give you an honorary dermatology degree. But more importantly, understand we're launching Nara here today in Australia. You as Australians, thank you. Thank you. Many of you have a predisposition to premature aging because of your genetic background from England. You do not have the degrees of melanin or melatonin that protects, melanin mainly, that protects your skin from UVA and UV damage. So you need to be particularly careful about sun exposure here, particularly careful about using sunscreen, which is in the daily moisturizer here, and particularly careful about really making sure you get the right amount of collagen so that your skin of your face and body can look its best. Thank you all.